Hello friends, I hope you are well. We woke up today in a new world order, and I thought it would never happen in a Western country. I mean, we imagined, out of all the places in the world, who would? And of course, the Communist government of China would, with their social points and face identification. It's like a dystopian future movie, but a Western country, well, that was far-fetched 6 months ago. It took a global pandemic for a democratic government to create a tracking app. And this week, the Australian government released their own version of the Trace Together app based on the Open Trace protocol, COVID Safe. So don't let the thoughts of how China is dealing with their population scare you. Australia is not China. So let's have a look at exactly how COVID Safe works, what it can and cannot do, and how it can help you and Australia fight the spread of COVID-19 and ultimately save lives. Let's start from the beginning. What is COVID Safe for? Well, the app is there to help track COVID-19 cases and those who have come into contact with people who have been infected. Currently, people have to remember who they spoke to and who they were in close proximity to in the last, let's say, 2 weeks. This app will digitize that process and help health officials connect the dots. The main benefit is to contact those who have been infected as quickly as possible to not only limit the spread, but also test and catch cases that might be life-threatening. So, who can access your data? Many people have been concerned about what kind of data is being captured and who can access it. Well, first state and territory health officials can only access app information if someone tests positive and agrees to the information on their phone of being uploaded, which is literally a button in the app. Further to that, the Australian health officials can only use the app information to help alert those who may need to quarantine or get tested. And straight from the government's website, this COVID Safe app is the only contact trace app approved by the Australian government. Thumbs up for that, I suppose. Now, currently the COVID Safe app is available in the Apple Store and Android Store. This would cover the highest population of smartphone users. Now, COVID Safe is not mandatory. However, our health minister has stated that at least 40% of the public needs to download it to make it work. Here is where the problem starts. At a population of 25 million, Australia needs at least 10 million people to download the app. However, international experts state it's not going to work unless there is at least 60% uptake, and some other numbers vary to at least 80 to 90%. Now, Prime Minister Morrison said automatic contact tracing would be a key component in states and territories easing some restrictions on high-value, low-risk economic activities after the next 4 weeks. He compared using the app to buying bonds during the war. I guess we're at war with an invisible entity. He said, in the war, people bought war bonds to get in behind the national effort. What we're doing in fighting this fight is we're asking people to download an app which helps us trace the virus quickly, and the more people who do that, the more we can get back to a more livable set of arrangements. The state government in New South Wales and Victoria have both indicated they will not make use of the app a condition for easing restrictions and will not require a certain percentage of the population to be using the app before restrictions will be eased. That is something to note. People won't be penalized for refusing to use the app or upload their data if they test positive, and the government has said it will be a criminal offense to refuse service, access to a venue or event for failing to use the app. This is not China, my friends. It certainly is not. You can download it right away now by searching COVID Safe. Now, after downloading the app, you have to provide some basic information. So we'll go through that now quickly. Your name, mobile number, and postcode. The phone number and postcode is crucial. I have doubts that if you need to put your real name in there is no real authentication for that, but remember that your phone number is tied to your official government ID, and this app only works with Australian phone numbers anyway. Now, to confirm your login, you will receive an SMS, and that's it, you're done. Then, your device generates a unique and encrypted reference code. This code is the ID that will get tagged and captured by other devices, so not your real details. The information stored on your device is also encrypted. Even you can't look at it yourself. The contact information stored in people's mobiles is deleted on a 21-day rolling cycle. This period takes into account the COVID-19 incubation period and the time it takes to get tested. Now, how does the tracing actually work? Well, the app uses low-power Bluetooth to announce itself and discover other devices. So then when you are nearby another person with the app, your device and their device will note down the date, time, distance, and duration of the contact and the other user's reference code. Now, to note, there is some confirmation around the time taken to announce this connection of the two devices, and it is around 15 minutes. So if you are spending more than 15 minutes with another person, that's when it actually apparently logs your information. Now, to confirm, the COVID Safe app does not collect your location. This does not track you. This has been confirmed by a Twitter user who jumped on and decompiled the app's code. Now, however much you can trust that, let's have a look at what they said. Now, decompiling will not let you see the app's source code, but it lets you see what the app can do and cannot do. Another thing to note about this is the code was not obfuscated, and that's why this user was able to decompile the code. And for peace of mind, we would prefer access to the source code, as we discussed in a previous video, and I'll link that below. However, the design and how it sends its reference codes via the API could allow it to track location somewhat, as it would consistently send device codes with a temp ID code across. And as you can see the screenshot here, the app is not asking for location data on the iOS, and compare that to the Google Maps where it is. However, on Android, it will ask permission for location services. Do note, however, that Google forces all Android apps to ask for location permissions, even if they don't use them. In order to use Bluetooth LE, technically, you could theoretically do location tracking if you had beacons all over the place. This is not the government's fault, it is Google. So to be effective, the app needs to continue to work in the background, and this can cause problems for some people, only due to their type of device. So how does this app affect your battery life? Well, the type of Bluetooth used is low power, so that's one positive. However, the app needs to be consistently running in the background. You can't quit it if you want to keep using it. So if you're one of those people who likes to clear all your background apps, either on Android or Apple, you can't do it with this app, because it's not going to continue working. You will, however, receive a notification daily to let you know that it is running correctly. Now, those on Android won't have a problem with this design, but due to the inherent design of the Apple iOS operating system, this is much more problematic. It is more difficult to keep the app running in the background, as it will drain more battery than on an Android phone. This, however, should not sway your decision. It is a very small difference, but it is there to note. Now, what happens if you come into contact with a person who has tested positive? Well, first of all, the health officials will not name that person. What you will get is a message like this in your app. Our records show that you may have been in contact with a confirmed COVID-19 case. Please contact us on the COVID-19 helpline, and this will be a local number displayed. I have also put a link in the legislation called Biosecurity, Human Biosecurity Emergency, Human Coronavirus with Pandemic Potential, Emergency Requirements, Public Health Contact Information, Determination 2020, that will stop anyone apart from the COVID-19 officials from accessing the data. Now, where is the data stored is a good question. Well, the government has decided to use the Sydney Amazon data centers. This data center hosts many of your banks, online services, Netflix, and many other large companies. They have highest security certification in Australia, both physical and digital. The data does not leave the country, and it is protected by all Australian privacy laws. However, the Australian government is also drafting up legislation to block the American government from accessing Amazon's data through their Patriot Act. As Amazon is an American company, it must comply with its country's requests. That's something to keep in mind. How that will get resolved is unknown, but it is a concern. Now back to the app. So far in my research, the consensus has been that there is nothing nefarious in this app. To note, if there was, the government would get crucified. And again, to note, time will tell. I like saying that, to note. So, what happens after the pandemic? Once all restrictions have been lifted and the green light is lit, the government will prompt all users to delete the app from their device. This will also delete all the data from their devices, and the data on the Amazon service will be destroyed. Also, you can delete the app from your device at any time. This too will delete all the local data, and if you would like your information deleted from the storage system sooner, you can fill out a request on their website to request deletion of your data from the Amazon service. So there you have it. The COVID Safe app is live and well. Let me know below if you will download it. I did a survey yesterday here on YouTube, though with only 54 votes, it's not really that interesting, but 67% of you said, no, you will not download it. And interestingly, only 3% from the minimum of having people actually succeed based on the health minister's notes. Friends, thank you very much for watching. I hope this has helped you understand what the app does and how it works. Let's chat about it in the comments below. I'd love to hear your thoughts about this as more information comes out. Remember to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and share this video with those who you think need help understanding how the COVID Safe app works. Thanks again for watching, and bye.